Hey everybody, I know I haven't made a movie for a while. Truth is, I haven't done a lot in the single player world, waiting for the next update. But I have done work on Enderbent, which I'll take in. I'll kind of run through some of the stuff I've added there. This is the new adventure map that I've been working on. Not much going on yet. Just this world seed is Amplified Train. Automator MC is the seed, and it's got a lot of cool features to it. So this one is going to be, instead of a urban type thing, it's going to be a little bit more open world. There'll be a little bit of walking, but I still promise you, you're not going to have to walk a long ways before seeing something cool. Because to me, maps like that, you might as well just play Minecraft Survival. Anyway, here's some of the things I've been looking at adding. Here's an execute command. We're at a fireworks entity. I summon a snowman. And it's kind of testing. This is the kind of the basic idea of what, how its principle of it's going to work. So this world, it's going to have kind of manic magic items. I'm not going to go overboard on it because I still feel that they're going to implement some of this stuff into the game to where you don't need command blocks. Pretty sure they'll do that. Anyway, it's set to where this entity will exist long enough to produce, I think, three snowmen. And there you have them, and I should have a sword so they don't mess up my map here. And they can be anything I want. They can summon anything I want. They can summon something that summons something else, and so on and so forth. And this is a timer here. This kills the fireworks entity. So when it detects that the fireworks entity exists, the amount of time it takes to get to that piece of redstone wire, it deletes it, which allows it to exist long enough to spawn three snowmen with this clock right here. And I got napalm right here, which a snowball. It'll set a block of fire at a snowball, and if the snowball is flying through the air, it has no place to set the block. It has to be touching something to put a block on it. So where it lands, okay, at first it didn't work, it'll make a fire. But it won't in the air. And that again can be, I can make that anything I want. And so this is just stuff I'm working with on here. Fireball. It's summons a fireball at an arrow. Or no, summons a fireball, yes, at an arrow with a direction of zero, so it's not moving. But the arrow will hit it and it will throw the fireball. Same as if you punch it. I also got one but that's in the other world where it's arrow is 1B, that means it's in the ground. That's what you normally see. This is something different. So, as soon as the arrow exists, it'll create the fireball and then it'll hit the fireball and move it. So, it's basically a fireball launcher. I don't think any of this stuff is really hard to do, so no doubt it exists already. I'm just showing you kind of what I'm messing with, and when the game is done, said and done, this is probably going to be vastly different than what I'm starting out with here. But this will be kind of cool, I think. I'm picturing like castle walls up there, maybe a little house up there, something down in the valley. It's pretty cool. Amplified Terrain, not very good for survival, but for adventure mapping, it's going to be great because there'll be bridges and everything. Anyway, that's enough of this. Here we are in Enderbent in the last patch update, which I'm calling Up 3, up for Update 3. I've finally kind of settled on the naming system. I've had things like Enderbent Enhanced and that. So I was always thinking that I'm gonna be done with it and not updated anymore. And when I did try a system where it was followed by a version number, it was just too confusing because a lot of people thought saw the version number and thought I was talking about Minecraft version number. So I think I've settled on up is what you're gonna, next time they have a snapshot and if they change something in the game that has to be fixed, it'll be Enderbent Up 4, and that's just gonna be the way it is. Here is one thing added, end game content here. If you beat the game all the way to the whole end of it and you're done, then you will get summoning stones here, and then you can summon Kronos in the overworld and fire. Whoop, a little bit of lag there, and fire spreads can be back on, and Kronos is one bad dude, and pretty cool too. He's gonna lay waste to a lot of this land while you're fighting him. You're gonna have full legendary gear at that point. So it's going to be pretty tough. Oh, I didn't notice this block sitting here. Oh well. I already uploaded the map and released it, so that'll just have to be there. So he's going to wipe out a lot of this map, but he's not going to do too much damage to you. It's going to take you a little bit to kill him. So since you have full gear already, gear is no use to you. So if you kill him the first time, you're going to get one special weapon you can use to aid in destroying this map. The first one, I think, is summon snowman, just like in the other world. And the second one is the napalm, and the third one is exploding arrows, but not the version you just saw with the fireball, a little different version. And as I said, those ones in the new adventure map are going to be vastly different by the time I'm done with them. So you can get three different rewards from him when you kill him. You can summon him as many times as you want. Okay, what else did I change on Enderbent? There's a meteor crater added. Where is that? I don't remember where I put it. There it is, over there. Meteor crater impact site. And that's kind of, there's something good in there, but you're gonna have a battle getting to it, I think. And I made a little list here. Oh, animations at spawn. There's a, now you're not the only ship when you first start the map. There's two other ships, and they are animated, so they run through scenarios, which is kind of cool to see. The Wild West Nile. I didn't have the star on there before because there was a problem with the beacons. The system that I designed for activating the beacons involves setting blocks with command blocks, and you're limited. You can't set a block in a chunk that's not loaded. So that's kind of far out there. So when you completed a dungeon, it was too far away to activate the beacon. So what this is now is the beacon is always on, and that's okay. That works out good. There's just one of them. So you could come here right away in the beginning of the game. It doesn't matter. Whenever you complete this and get the star, the beacon will shut off. It's not a really hard dungeon, so you could do it the first one, but it's hard enough you could do it the last one and still, it'll be fun for you. What else? Oh, Big Island. Sure, I'm on the whole opposite side of the map. Oh, a lot of little tweaks, like the Moses Stone over there, which is part of a quest. I made it bigger and easier to see. There's always beta testing going on with this, with multiple players. So every little tiny tweak that can be made, it's not really important, but can you change this, and it gets changed. That's just the way it rolls. Just going for 100% perfection. And as far as I know, we're there, but So I was heading for Big Island. The villagers now are active. The smart villagers, I called them. If it's kind of like Zelda, when you kill the chickens, you fight the chicken boss if you kill too many of them. Well, this is sort of a spin-off of that. If you piss off too many villagers, you're gonna pay for it. See if I might be on peaceful. I am. Turn on easy. If you don't mess with them, everything will be fine. But if you do, get a warning, get another warning, and then you're in serious trouble. Now these blazes, when they first spawn, they're like hyper, they have hyper speed. They're not shooting me because I'm in creative. But then shortly after, they settle down and they calm down. But they can do a lot of damage in the meantime, and it's also resets, starts over if you start killing them again. But yeah, you go through the houses and you can get emeralds and some loot and stuff like that. So this is pretty much polished off a little bit. It's always more that can be done in places, but I think now Big Island is pretty well completely finished. What else is on my list? The XP shop at Spawn. That was set to open after you've completed, I think, the third dungeon. But that was one of the per beta tester suggestions. One thing that was changed. It is now open all the time. So you warp up here right away. You can see a map of the world. And you can, if you have the XP requirements, you can get this up. And the cost is lowered. So 25 levels, you can get this. That's 30 minutes of 20% armor, which is, you know, it makes you pretty damn powerful for 30 minutes. At 25 levels, that's, I would say, a pretty good deal. Depending on how you play the game. If you an average player, then you're going to get 25 levels pretty quick. If you do a hardcore run like me and Flying Z do once in a while, just run through it, test it, you probably won't get 25 by the time you beat the game. But we have not beat the game on hardcore yet, so if you can do that, then you'll have one up on us. We have gotten very close. We've been in the inland many times, but we've never we cannot say we've officially beat this game on hardcore. What else? Oh, exit some of the dungeons, like the first dungeon, Ice Dungeon. When you get to the end, it's kind of a long haul, and so there's just a command block there. After you beat the boss, you just hit the button, and it says on it, teleport you back to the entrance. That's done on anyone, which you might consider a pain in the butt to traverse back out of. Especially good if you're doing a speed run, and you run and you bypass all the mobs to get to the boss. You can warp to the beginning, so you don't have to fight through the mobs twice, you know, to get back out. What else? Oh, some bosses were upgraded. Some bosses were upgraded. Some were fixed. Like, for one boss, he was a zombie with a bow, and zombies don't use bows. So it was just like a little error that I missed. So that was changed, and in general, improvements to how bosses act. Just too much boring stuff to go through. I think that's it. That covers the expansion to Enderbent. I didn't cover all, again, like the suggestions from beta testers, tweaks here and there. I don't even remember what they all are. I fix them right away and move on. So there's dozens of little things here and there that are fixed. You know, there's a little more food in some areas, things like that. You know. So now I'm going to show you a little bit I did in Terraria. I don't have tons of new stuff to show you. If you play Terraria at all, you know about the new fishing quests, and you have to get the fishing stuff in certain biomes, and yeah, but that's all stuff that you'll probably want to find out on your own. What I have made here, which is something that you possibly might not have seen, is a little farm. In the mushroom biome, underground mushroom biome, is where truffle worms spawn. So what I have set up here is a little place for me to fish, and I use sonar potion so I don't reel it in unless it's something I want, crate potion so I get something I want, and then a fishing potion. Plus I have all the fishing gear, the angler set from the fishing quests, earring and tackle box. So I just sit down here and fish, and I'm not certain about mornings, but I think it's the case. But I'm positive about nighttime. That's when you're going to get a truffle worm. If it's during the day, let's check the time. It's 10:34 p.m. So they should. It's getting close to around the time where they're going to start spawning. And I just pretty much hang out here. I do my summon, and then I fish, and eventually a truffle worm is going to show up. And when he does, I just come on out. I either walk over and grab him, or if it's too busy, then I can come down here, and I have actuator blocks and all these. So I hit the button, and then everything drops. It's also a good way to get mushrooms. There was no truffle worm, so And also, I put these down here mainly because I had them. It might be hard for you to see. These spiky ball traps just kill everything around here. That's just increase my spawn rates. If there's nothing down here, something's more likely to spawn up here. In theory, not necessary. I just did it because it seemed like something fun to do. Now, they're kind of rare spawns. That's why I built this thing to maximize them. And so you just sit here and you fish and get all the fish and crates and stuff you want. Truffle worm shows up, you go grab them. And then you warp back to town, because once you have a truffle fish in your inventory, you can't fish anymore. I just throw them in this chest, and then I come back with my magic character, which is exclamation point. And then I get the truffle worm, and then I go to where I fight him, which is ocean. They made it longer. Oh, I have a potion, mining potion. I could warp directly there if I wanted to run the redstone, but I just I don't have that set up right now. See, I already fought him, so I have this weapon, which is pretty dang good weapon. This bubble weapon right here, used on bosses and pumpkin moon or frost moon events. Major damage, short range. It's okay because you're geared for taking damage and health and healing yourself. This one I use for long range because it seeks them out. So if I'm going through caves or something, it will also light up the caves for me. So then here is the ocean. If I had a truffle worm on me, which I currently do not, I would start fishing with a truffle worm. Duke Fishron would spawn. I would switch to my bubble weapon, and I would take care of him in short order. And that's kind of that. Over here is just where I do my fishing. Now, a trick you can do, it's the biome you're in. Oh, this isn't doing it now. It must have changed. But it was like half one biome, half the other. In whatever biome I'm standing on, that's what I would be fishing. So if I had a quest to do something in a crimson, say, you could set it up to fish the crimson. If you're standing right here, just move over here to fish just general woods area, whatever. I didn't do that. I was just pointing that out, that it'd be something easy to do. So that's pretty much what I got for Terraria. Killed everything, got all the bosses. Oop, warping around. This area is still the same for summoning bosses. Oh, got the ammo crate. Still determined that the ranger guy without support is useless because he dies just way too quick. No kind of self-heal. But if you have a mage that's just set up to heal, then he does a lot of damage. And you got new ammo crate, so it reduces ammo that you use. Really good damage dealer, but worthless without support. The summoner is better. Got new summoner equipment. And I have the daggers that have health steal on them. So if I use a summoner to fight a boss, I just constantly hit him with the not much damage dealing daggers. It's a melee weapon, but they gives me health steal. Keeps him alive for a little while. But this is by far the magic character, still the go-to one for fighting bosses. And I just sit down during whatever event it is. I just kind of walk back and forth with this and get my health back. Let's see. They don't seem to drop as much. It seems like they reduce the drop rates, but that's not a really big deal. Potions. Got battle potion, which you can take it or leave it. Magic power. That's a gotta have. Thorns. Take it or leave it. Iron skin. With this character, not totally necessary. Regeneration, not totally necessary. Endurance potion, pretty nice to have. It reduces your damage that you take. And then some food. That's pretty much that. Okay, now when they release, which should be any day now, the new update of Minecraft with the water dungeons, that'll be interesting. That'll be lots to do. It'll be more stuff to do in the single player world, so I'll get back on that. Right now I'm kind of holding off because I've already built everything like 5 times, and just to my knowledge, I have it all optimized. It's about as far as it can go. So, something new will be cool. All right, I will see y'all on the next one.